Hello, wonderful people, places. My name's Aaron Snowflake, and today we're going to be doing character creation. So this is something I wanted to do for a long time, and I had tons of these recorded where I did this. Essentially, it's when I go into different, like, character makers and stuff, and create little characters. Today we're going to be playing a game called IMVU, which, if you can judge by the credits up there, is a pay-to-play game that I play way too much, and this is my default avatar. And what I really like doing on this game is I really enjoy making, like, avatars and things of that nature. I spent too many credits on this outfit, and I regret every second of it. So today we're going to be making a Halloween-themed character because, you know. For starters, we're going to do a girl because they have more options in here. I do have a female avatar. Why do I have a female avatar, you ask, when I am a boy who is very androgynous? Because I am a boy who is very androgynous, and she is naked, and that makes me uncomfortable. So we're gonna just put something random on her. Yep, that's, or this, or, yeah, or that's still revealing. We'll just make her goth. So today we're gonna be making a Halloween-styled avatar, because I think this is a fun game, and we're gonna change the head, because I fucking, yeah, anime style, what? We're gonna go into the eyes and look for female only. There we go. Because those are good quality. So if you're new to my channel and you haven't seen my content before, hello, my name is Aaron Snowflake, and I make YouTube videos sometime. I should be editing Mythforce right now, but I'm not, so here we are. Yeah, Mythforce is this project I started a while ago, and it's essentially a mythology-themed show, and I just keep worrying that I'm gonna have to cancel it, because it's so much fucking work just for one episode, and I didn't really anticipate it being as much work as it ended up being. And it's just hell having to do it all by myself. And I can't afford to pay people because I'm lower income. I don't have money. Speaking of which, I made a merch store, so that's a thing. But I don't have any fans, so it also doesn't matter. So yeah, we're gonna go with, like, a gothic kind of angel for today's outfit. And this is just gonna be me talking to you guys as we do this. So yeah. Ooh, I love that. I should probably take off the horns. Those don't look very gothic. Do I have any skins that we can use? Yes, I do. This is probably... That looks like garbage, and I hate it. If you're wondering, ooh, I love that. Okay, that works. That's kind of fair. I think I had female model because I actually, I don't know if this contradicts what I just said earlier, I have the memory of a squirrel, because I did role plays, and also I had a store on here where you can get the trans pride eyes, where I sold queer pride products that you can't get anymore because, you know, you have to be a VIP to do that kind of thing. So yeah, overall, in general, I'm kinda really, really stressed out. I don't have much reason to be stressed out, or at least not much reason I can openly discuss with you. But what I will say is that I have not been having a good time with my life, and things are stressful in the RN Club. My company is basically going to be dissolved because I can't afford $200. $300 to keep it going, and my mom refused. Oh, this is like a complete outfit. Oh, cross shot. This is a complete outfit right here, but we'll keep going. So it's basically gonna be dissolved, and also you know, not only that, but my family is really struggling financially right now, so that's not fun at all, but I'm surviving. My camera broke, so I haven't been able to make traditional YouTube videos in a while, and my emoji hand backfired. So it seems like I've just been having the worst luck lately, but that's okay, Because I'll be fine. I kind of want to buy this outfit. Is that bad? I signed up for Hulu, when I had extra money, and that's a while ago, and that's how I got all these credits. $5 got me more than it normally would in the game, and yeah, I kind of have to pay with real money for this game, which is very stupid, but you know. So yeah, my depression's been super, super bad, and I don't know what to do about it. I mean, I can't really do anything about it necessarily. I kind of just want to buy this outfit so I can have it. How much is it? Oh, it's only 5,000 credits. I think that's everything we can do with this outfit. Watch all the credits go down. I should really. Okay, so that would be a really short episode, so we're probably gonna do a male gothic one now for Halloween. I'm gonna control shift print screen that. So like in general, I'm just kinda we'll start off with a base because oh, that's a terrible base. Okay, let's try this. Cool, now let's remove all the gadgets and gizmos he's wearing. You know, I just kinda I want to do music, and the issue is I'm not very good at music, so I know that's not gonna happen. And so my second choice is acting. But here's the issue with that. My teeth are really fucked up right now, so nobody's gonna hire me. You know, nobody's gonna hire me with my he has female mandibles. Nobody's gonna hire me with my teeth being the way they are. And I can't afford to get a new headshot and my haircut's changed. If you change any little thing about your appearance, you have to get a new one. And it costs money to be an actor, and I feel like that's something nobody really talks about. It's really expensive to be an actor or to get your foot in the door of acting. You have to have a video reel, you have to have a headshot, and you have just have to do the things just to get an agent. And also, I'm not like traditionally attractive, you know? Like, I'm normally cast as the fat, funny guy. You know, I'm fucking emo. Like, I'm not someone who's leading man material, so I don't even know if acting really is for me. I mean, there is acting for everyone, and I've got on people that I'm professionally trained, I have a pretty wide range. I'm voicing two twin girls in an upcoming visual novel because I can. A long story short, I was on hormone blockers because I had a transgender phase, which turned out not to be true to who I was. I'm not a girl, I'm a boy. Oh, I fucking love this hair. And I just like cross-dressing, you know? I don't identify as female. And like. So I was on hormone blockers from age 13 till now, and I'm going off them, so my voice is dropping. And I'm probably gonna lose that acting role. So I look about 16, so I can play younger roles, which I guess is good, but like on the other hand, I don't have an agent, my teeth are fucked up, and I'm not exactly, you know, leading material. And like in the voiceover world, as soon as my voice finally drops, I'll be able to play like tons of different parts, you know. I'm just gonna spend all my credits today. I'd be able to play tons and tons of different parts once that happens, because I have a really wide acting range. You guys have seen my Let's Plays. But I feel like, you know, we'll do a pirate. I feel like because I don't look like stereotypically attractive, that that's just not gonna happen. And I'm also writing a novel right now. I'm writing about three different stories. I'm writing a lesbian love story right now called My Beloved Demon, because of course I am, about an angel named Ashe who falls in love with the princess of hell. And so that's interesting. Yeah, that's fun. So I'm writing that, and then I'm writing The Kingdom Diaries, which is a story Oh, tired. It's like 11:13 Halloween, which is a story about a world where people are segregated based on gender identity and sexual. Oh, I fucking love this. And sexual orientation. Okay, that's essentially what it's about. And all my divination, because you guys know I mess with black magic and stuff. All my magic has told me that it's really not going to be like particularly well liked once it comes out. And that worries me because like you can not believe in anything I do. You can think I'm like the stupidest stupid person to ever stupid. But I do put effort into everything I do. Right? Like I spend a lot of time on all my projects, and I spend too much time, a lot of time in stuff that people never really get to see. I spent a lot of time and effort into Feminism Fighters, which just blew up in my face because one, it was a feminist audio drama. Nobody likes that. And two, even political agenda aside, it just wasn't very good. Oh, I fucking love this. Okay, yes, this is coming along splendidly. And so I feel like, I spend so much more effort in things than what ends up coming of it. And I'm just like, when is it gonna pay off? When is my big break gonna happen, if I ever have one? Like, I don't want to be famous. Let's make that clear. I don't want to be famous. I don't need to be a celebrity. I don't need people to have a fan base. Like, I do these Let's Plays. I'm never gonna get an audience. And I understand that. Like, it's mostly me just talking to a void, and I'm aware of that. But a part of me definitely wants to be appreciated for my work, and I put so much effort in. And then there's another part of me that's like, is this even really good? Because I don't have self-esteem issues. I used to. Like, a very long time ago, I hated myself, and then eventually through magic, one of the first things that changed about me, because it is a path of change, is getting rid of that insecurity. And I don't hate myself anymore. When it comes to like seeing people who are really good at stuff, sometimes I get insecure. Oh, I love this even more. Sometimes I get insecure, but for the most part, it's just that insecurity because in comparison. I don't even really compare myself that often anymore, so insecurity isn't really an issue with me. I mean, I'm not happy with my life and I'm not happy where things are going, but insecurity isn't, the big problem that I'm facing. Oh, I fucking love this. But they look noob. I love this, but the bottoms, they look so newbie. Should we keep it, guys? No, we're not. We're gonna change it. And so I'm dealing with a lot right now. And it's like my YouTube channel. I spend hours like on each video, getting lighting, preparing. I'm gonna start doing makeup for them. Oh, I fucking love these, but they don't match the vest. And so it's really stressful. And like, you guys aren't my therapist. I say you guys, like anyone's actually watching. If you're actually watching this, leave a comment. I would love that. It keeps me alive and going. Okay, yeah, these are good. We're gonna keep these and change this. No, actually, these look cartoony. These look cartoony. Well, let's just do some ripped jeans. And so I'm just, I'm mentally ill, and I'm stuck, doing that. I feel like no matter what I make, it's not even that I won't be happy with it, because to a level, if I fucking make something, I love it. you know, I made something. But yes, I love this avatar. you know, I flip and made something. How many people can say that they made something? But also, on the other hand, it's like, okay, his body is contorting in ways it shouldn't. you know, it's like nobody else likes the thing I worked years on. Why should I even bother to make things at all? And yeah, I think he's finished. Okay, so this is our pirate captain. Let me put him in a pose. Not that pose.
Kitty are destined to be together one day.
Oh, that's my Nepeta voice box. You guys want to hear me do awful Nepeta impressions?
Meow rails.
Yeah, it's great. I have a wide range. But yeah, this is our pirate. He's all done. We'll do one more. I think we'll do a fairy princess, and we'll actually set out to do a fairy princess. That is gonna be something we're going to attempt. So let's put on our girl that we got all dressed up. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. I shouldn't have bought that eye patch. That eye patch. Wow, she is saying something with that outfit. What is she saying? I don't know. But yeah, so that's just kind of where I am right now. And like, people hate me. Like, I know people hate me. Like, most people I've come into contact with do not like me, and it's not that I've done anything particularly wrong, because most of the time they hate me for really like arbitrary reasons. Like, I don't fit into a socialized box that they like, or I, you know, I'm or I'm insane, or it's just something out of my control, or something that isn't that big of a deal in retrospect. And it bothers me when people hate me for stuff that isn't my fault, you know? And people do hate me for stuff that isn't my fault. But, you know, I think that's just like a part of being an adult. It's a part of everything. And me taking issue with you taking issue with me isn't really gonna solve anything. I mean, I can hate you for it or be mean about it, but it's not gonna change the fact that, ooh, what's this? Oh, I hate that. It's not gonna change the fact that you still hate me for something that isn't my fault. You know, I've lost a lot of people, close to me. Just in general, you know, I've lost a lot of people. I was codependent on my best friend, and I have a mental disorder I'm not gonna disclose here, because as soon as I name it, people go, oh, what? And they act like I'm some monster, and I don't want that relationship with you guys. Ooh, I love these ears. But like, I have a mental disorder, and I was so sick, and I was really bad for a while, and I was so sick that he just abandoned me. And like, I already have, oh, she's perfect, really bad abandonment issues. We have to do the feet now. I already have pretty severe abandonment issues. Like, those are definitely a thing that I suffer from. And having the one person I told everything to, who promised they'd always be there for me, just turn around and give up on me like that. I don't know. And they were kind of abusive to me when we were friends, so I guess I shouldn't have thought as highly of them as I did. But, yeah, distraught over it, and like, this keeps happening. I keep messing up, or people don't give me the light of day, or my mental health gets in the way, and I keep losing people, you know? And as someone with severe abandonment issues, when you're just ghosted like that, like, I knew this person named Crocker, who was an avid liar, They would not be afraid to make up a giant lie to get someone in trouble. And, you know, they pretended to have DID. And I'm just like, there's no such thing as a system of only fictives. That doesn't exist. And, like, they pretended to have a lot of things, and there's call-out posts made about them, and then they curse the person who called them out, and they just were a very bad person. But, like, that was my friend. You know, that was someone who relied on me for a lot of emotional support, and I was there for a lot of their emotional support, but they were never there for me. You know? Crocker was never there for me. I was always their rock, but they could never be mine. And I feel like that's how it is with a lot of my relationships. Like, I'm always the person that people can count on, but nobody's there for me because I'm a good person. And I deserve, you know, good things. But I don't ever get them. And, you know, I don't think it's God or anything, because I don't believe in God. Well, it's not that I don't believe in God, I believe in everything. I don't worship God. So, like, I don't have some supernatural force I can blame. I just have a tough time. So I think we're done. This is our fairy princess. I'm gonna buy this outfit because this is fucking cute. Let me not buy everything. Let me remove some of the stuff in the scene because hold on. Oh, I see why it's so expensive. It was a bundle. Okay, so I don't know who's filming a video. Talk to you in a second. So let me just buy this outfit. So let's see. It hurts my credits because I don't have credits very often. This will be great for role play. And they'll find out I'm a guy afterwards, and they'll be like, "What?" I actually have a book of a lot of my role plays, if you want to see that. But look at her, isn't she so cute? So these are the outfits we created today. We made Pirate Boy, who I didn't save or buy. Oh no, I bought the wand. Fuck, I didn't want to buy the wand. Okay, well, okay then. So these are the outfits we made today. We made Pirate Boy, who I can't show you because, yeah. We made Fairy Girl, and we made Goth Girl. And these are like the same fucking person. It's just like different outfits. Clothes really do make the person. Look at this. So we got Goth Girl and Fairy Girl. And just to fill it up with a few more outfits, this is one of my default avatars. He looks tired. Like, he looks tired. And then we also got Emo Boy. This is my default avatar because I am going through my emo phase, even though I'm 22. So yeah, that's been today's video. I'll link the wallpaper I'm using and the background engine in the description down below. I just wanted to do something Halloween themed. You know, I'm gonna get an anime avatar soon so I could be like one of those virtual YouTubers. And I'm gonna keep it as far away from what I actually look like as possible, outside of like the bangs in the face, because I just want it to look like what I wish I looked like rather than what I do. So it's gonna be like a really cool avatar with like red hair because my hair's red. But yeah, that's gonna happen, and hopefully my views will skyrocket when it does. But until then, this has been today's episode, and we designed her, and here she is. All right, talk to you guys next time.